ओके सो गुड मॉर्निंग गुड इवनिंग एवरीवन, वी वेलकम यू ऑल टू द क्लब सर्विस ऑन गेट गिटहब एंड ओपन सोर्स। वी होप दैट यू विल बी एबल टू स्टार्ट योर डेवलपमेंट एंड ओपन सोर्स जर्नी फ्रॉम टुडे। एम आई ऑडिबल?
यस संकेत।
सो लेट अस स्टार्ट विद आवर इंट्रोडक्शंस। So, I am Sanket Sonavane from SOS EAC. I am in the development team in ACM.
Hello guys, I am Devang. I am from second year computer science and I am on the sessions team of ACM student chapter. While I am majorly a web developer and I also code in Python. And we hope you enjoy the session today. Yeah, so let's begin.
Okay. So first we will see what is Git and what are version control systems. Version control system is a kind of software which is used to track changes to the source code, including who made the change and what the change is. It is also used for communicating the changes to the team. So Git is a system used for tracking changes to in any set of files. It is the most widely used VCS. It can be downloaded and installed from gitscm.com.
Okay, so version control, yeah, Git. What is the use of version control, right? As the name suggests, it controls the version. You can see different, like, you know, if I have a game, I've created a game and I create a game and I make a minor change in it. Then my friend says, you know what? I can add this one for you, and I make something and I make it a game too. Then someone else comes in, everything changes, right? Code always evolves, which means that if I am coding something, I have to keep one part of it. Then if I should not break it, so I will make a copy of that code and I will code in that and I will make some change. Like, this happens very often, right? So it's very inefficient to store files like that. So there was the birth of version control systems. And instead of storing four files, as you can see here, we can just store one file and a Git file. Okay. And can we move to the next slide? So another use of version control is who changed my code. So when a lot of people are working together, say I am working with Vishal, I'm working with Sankit, and I write an algorithm which just works. And the first rule of programming, if it works, don't touch it. Someone changed that and now the entire code has broken. Now who should I blame? It's not me, because I made the code work. Shall I blame Vishal? Shall I blame Sanket? I don't know. But in version control, we can see who exactly made the change. You can track that as well, which is why it's very important to use version control systems in development. And when you join any company, you will be given, you are assigned with your own account of version control in the company. So, that being said, let's move on. Okay, GitHub. Can I take the screen share?
Sure.
Yeah, thank you. Guys, is the screen visible?
Yes.
Great. So you see this earth that we took away, right? In the first page. So this is GitHub. It's the Reddit for programmers. It is the most important software that you will probably see. It's one of the most important websites in the world. What it does is that it's a place where 65 million, that is 6.5 crore developers, 30 lakh organizations work. And it's one of the Fortune 50 companies as well, which means, yeah, bahut paisa. Then what is it used for is you can keep a track of every code that you ever write, right? Like this, you can also collaborate with each other. And now, even though GitHub is since what, 20 years now, it's still evolving. There is an app now on GitHub that you can take it from Play Store. You cannot make commit changes, but you can see the code. Then it's still working that now it has its own text editor. You don't need to have a text editor from outside, right? It's still evolving. Everything is still work in progress. You are never done. You can find everything. All these terms, if you feel like you don't understand what is fixing, what is merging, we will learn that very soon. And this is just to get you excited about what GitHub is all about. Then, okay, let me sign into my account first. this is my account. So when you get into an account, what do you see as the first page is the recent activities, what we did. This is your favorite senior Suyash, and you can see his work. Like every one of us has a GitHub profile where you can see our codes, our projects, what we do, and right. We hope that we are sharing all these repositories with you, and we hope that you'll be excited. And these are all the recent repositories that I've been working on. These are all the explore repositories. So what GitHub allows me to do is take a look at someone else's code, take a look at, I can store my codes, and also it allows me to make changes. It allows me to develop their code, improve their code as well as my code. Now, everyone has heard of Flutter, right? It's a language by Google, which you can code in. If you once code an application in it, it can work on Android, iOS, web, you know, car ka UI, IoT devices, everywhere. It's completely open source. Open source as in anybody can contribute to it. That we'll see later. But this is just a glimpse of what GitHub can do for you. And let's move on with the session. So next is creating a repo. Sanket, back to you.
So first, let us see what a repository is. A repository, commonly known as repo in short, is a container where we want version control. It is basically a folder where we keep the project source code and want to track changes. It is a local copy. We also have a term called remote in this world, in this open source and GitHub world. A remote is a common repository stored in the cloud, for example, GitHub. It is shared among all the team members who are contributing to the project. So now, we will create a new repository. To create a new repository, we have two commands. Either we can use git init to create a local repository, or we can use GitHub and create a repository in the cloud and then clone it. Cloning a repository means downloading the contents of the repository from the cloud to our machine. So let us first see how git init is executed. So this is an empty folder. I will create a new folder here with the name new project. This is just an empty folder right now. If we go to the command line, type git init, an empty git repository will be created. We can see that the .git hidden folder is present here. Now let us do the same thing on GitHub, which is more easier than git init, because we have to perform additional commands to then connect it to GitHub. On GitHub, you have to click on the plus sign and then on the new repository. We name the repository, we give the repository a unique name. Let us give ACM git. Description is optional. We can choose whether the repository is public or private. Public means that anyone can view the repository and try to contribute, as we will show in the open source part. Private means that nobody can view the repository except the persons with authorized access. So let us keep it public. I will add a readme file and create the repository. So our new repository is created. The readme file only has the heading, which is the name of the repository itself. And now let us add Devang as a contributor. So I have added Devang as a collaborator. Let us see how we can clone this repository. To clone this repository, we have the command git clone and the URL. The URL is the URL of the repository itself. So let us copy this URL and open the command line and do git clone and the URL. And we have loaded the repository which we have created in GitHub. Right now it's empty. It's technically not empty. It has the readme file, which is almost empty. It just has a heading. So next, part will be taken by Devang.
Sorry, I was muted. Okay, so my screen is visible. Hello?
Yes, it is visible.
Great. So, okay, so now since Sanket had added me as a collaborator, I can also work on the project. Now, if I am told, if I will receive an email from GitHub asking, ki, do I want to be a collaborator to this project since I've been invited and here it is. So, I will just accept it. And okay, so once I accept this, I can also code in it. And what let's first do is, as Sanket did, we should clone this repository on our private thing, right? Ignore all of this. So okay, let's clone it here itself. I'm gonna write the magic words. Okay, remember all of this, because if you learn this 5 or 6 lines of code, you will probably know 99% of Git that you'll ever use. So Git space clone space and the URL of the repository. So I can directly download it. And now where is it? Here. Now I can make any change that I want in this. And let me do just that. So I'll open my text editor. Let's say it's VS Code. Okay, so we can make any changes, right? Now, I'm a very movie watching person. So that's what we'll make. Let's say a movie.json file. Okay. Guys, that day you recommended me some movies, right? I hope you remember. So get ready, because I'll be asking you some movies and their reviews. Okay. So we start with this. And okay, if this is the form, okay, JSON format, guys, JavaScript object notation. This is the format in which all the world's applications run. This is how internet works. Internet sends data through JSON. You don't have to learn more about this. If you want to learn, tell us. This would be a part of the next session. Okay. And oh boy. So let me just write something in it. So the name of the first movie that we'll be reviewing is, acha, recommend a good movie, guys. Anybody?
Chhore.
Chhore. Spelling, if possible. C H H.
Hello.
I C. Yes. Hello is a movie. Kunti movie hai. My mother is. Kunti movie hai. Okay. Acha. But asil chhan asil. So this is the name of the movie, right? Now, I want you to give me the reviews, okay? So, Chichore ko kya review doge, guys?
9.8,
okay. Itna acha. And? Hello? Come on, guys. Achhi nahi lagi, theek hai. Cringe tha gaana, rona aata hai last mein. Come on. Don't be shy.
9.
8.
Yeah, 8 now. I'm also thinking, okay, I'll also vote it. I'm gonna go say 7 because J clear nahi hota uska. And okay, let's just keep it that way. We can add more files as Sanket would change the file more. But as of now, this is what our file is. Chichore will be reviewed by 3 people. Now, if I make a change to a repository, this is no longer the same file as Sanket has. So I have to push it. So in order to push a file, I have to push the file. So now for that, the three magic words, not the one that you think of, are going to be used. Okay. Let me just check. And let's just check the status. I added one file called movie.json. Now I have to push it. So to push the entire change, I will just git space add space dot. Remember this, git space add space dot, then git commit -m stands for message. What message do you want to add? So I just added a movie called CHHICHOPI. I'm just guessing the movie name, and this has been changed. And now we're gonna get push origin main. The last line is probably a bit confusing. I will tell you that main is the name of a branch to which you are pushing. Branch, what is a branch? Sanket will soon tell you, but this is the main branch. Every code starts in the main branch. After you execute these three codes, after you execute these three lines, your code is updated. Now, movie.json is everywhere. Movie.json can be viewed by you as well. If you go to this particular link, it's open for everybody. Now, on to Sanket to show you more about it.
Yes. Is the screen visible?
Yes, Sanket.
So as we can see, the movie.json file is created in the cloud on in the GitHub repository. But let us open this in VS Code. But in my local copy, the movies.json file is missing. This is because my copy is not updated with the common copy we are sharing on the GitHub. So I have two commands for this. That is git fetch and git pull. What git fetch does is it will download all the data of changes which were applied on the GitHub repository which are missing from our copy of the repository. And what git pull will do is that it will apply all those changes and show the actual status of the actual condition of the repository to us. So let us execute it. We will do git fetch. And it has downloaded the changes. And now we can see the status. It says that your branch is behind origin main by one commit. And it can be fast forwarded. So this means that there is one extra commit on GitHub which is missing from our copy. So let us do git pull. After git pull, we see that the movies.json file is there and we can see all the contents which Devang has added. Let us also add one more movie to the list. This new movie.
Catch me if you can.
Let us now run git status. So git status shows right now that we have modified the file movies.json. So let us add it to the staging area. What a staging area is that we can make changes in any number of files at a time, but only the changes added in the staging area will be committed. Now let us check. It has been staged, and we can check this by the color. This shows red that we have not staged, and this shows green, which means we have staged. So let us commit it.
I'm sorry to interrupt, but what do you mean by stage?
Suppose you have 10 files and you have made changes in all 10 of them, but the actual changes were like two independent tasks assigned to you. So you cannot commit those both tasks simultaneously, combining them and making a single commit. So what you will do, you will only stage the particular changes which are for task one and then commit it. What happens is that only those changes which are staged will be committed. So only task one will be committed. Then you can stage the rest of the task and then commit it. Have you understood?
Yes, sir. I got it. Thank you.
Can we do it on Android?
I don't think it is better to do this on Android. It may be possible somehow, but it's not recommended. because you cannot develop software using mobile phones.
Let me tell you something. There is this app called Termux. Okay, Termux, if you can use it, T-E-R-M-U-X. What it gives you is the functionality that you can use your phone as a, you can have a terminal, Ubuntu terminal in your phone. So yes, it is possible, as you said, because you know, it's a device, right? It has its own operating system, has its own APIs, but it's not recommended, and it's not actually like you have to just download Git on that terminal and you have to do the exact same procedures as he did. I know you're excited to do this, but I would still suggest not to, because giving terminal access to an Android phone is very risky. I had to do that by routing my phone, and I lost half of my data, and I could not, you know, get it back, because, you know, warranty goes when you root your phone. COC users ko pata hoga. And so prefer not to. And if you want version control, I'll show you a better way after this, after Sanket teaches you branching. Right now, let's continue with the session.
Okay, so let us commit this. I will enter the message. Catch. Has been committed. We can see the log that it has been committed. So log by default gives a big log, but we just need a single line log. So it is initial commit, which was when we created the readme file along with the repository. The second was Chichore, and the third is this one. Now we haven't pushed this, so it is not present on GitHub. So let me push it. Now this change is also visible on GitHub. Catch me if you can, is visible here. You can also check all your commit history. By clicking here, it will show you all your history and what changes was made in that commit. Okay, so have you understood till now? If you have any doubts, you can ask.
Yes, understood.
Okay, so let's move ahead. So next we have branching. It is one of the basic topics, but little bit advanced as compared to the basic 4-5 commands we have studied till now. So let me give you an example. Consider that you are doing an assignment which is very important, and it has some easy questions, it has some difficult questions, and suppose you have completed all the easy questions on a single page of paper and there is some space left. So what you will think is that the difficult questions need to be tried out before they are written, because you don't know how to solve them exactly. So you will not write them on the same piece of paper which has the space remaining. You will take a different rough sheet and try out different approaches for it. And when you will find the actual approach, you will take that sheet and combine it with the original sheet. So that's what we are doing here. We have a single branch at this point of time. And then we have created, this is the main branch which was originally there, and we created a new branch. Why do we create a new branch is that for freely, we can experiment with anything without breaking anything on the master branch or the main branch. Today it is known as main branch because GitHub has changed the name after the Black Lives Matter riots. Before it was known as master branch. So when you will create a new branch, you can freely change anything there and it will not be affected in the original branch. So there is no, you need not be scared that anything will break or you might delete accidentally a very important file. Though it can be recovered, then also nothing will break. Another thing is that having separate branches allows us to have modularity. Like if we create a new branch for adding a new feature, it is more maintainable than combining everything in a single branch. So as we can see in the diagram, the master branch also had some changes and the new branch also had some changes. After we decide that okay, our work is complete, if we are experimenting and we just wanted to try out things, we may even decide to delete the branch because it is no longer required. We just wanted to test if something is possible or not or anything. Or if we are developing a new feature or fixing some issue, then we have to merge it with the original branch. What merging will do is that it will take the code of the master branch, the original branch and the new branch, and will try to merge it. While merging, if there are no conflicts, it will just create a new merge commit and the both the branches will be in sync. But if there are some conflicts, then it will tell where there is issue and we can fix it. So for branching, we have three basic commands: git branch, which shows the branches available to us, git checkout, and branch name. This will change the current branch we are working on, and git merge branch name, which will merge the given branch name with the current branch we are on. So let's try this out. Now, what are the branches available? So we only see a main hidden over here because there is only a single branch right now. We can do get checkout minus b, and I will give the minus b specifies create a new branch here. There is also a different command, but this is more quick because it creates a new branch and also switches it. So let us give it a name, new branch. Let us see now. So we have two branches, main and new branch, and the new branch is highlighted, indicating that it is the one currently active. So let's add another movie. Can you please tell me?
Radhe.
Are
it's a good movie. It's bhai ka movie.
Okay. Any reviews?
Minus one.
Okay. 9.3.
How do you write infinity?
Zero.
Either kuch bhi likh sakte, koi problem.
11 on 10.
Inverse of infinity.
Ten. Okay, so let us commit this change. Let us first see the status. We have modified the movies.json. It also shows what branch we are on. It says we are on the branch, new branch, and we have modified movies.json. We can also see what the changes are by going here and the git section of VS Code and clicking this. It shows what exactly the change is. So these lines of code are missing here. It is the original part and this is the new part. So let's stage it. Okay, so let us check the log. We have the commit of Radhe on the new branch. So let us go back to the main branch. Git checkout main. Now we see that the section is missing. This is because we created changes, we committed changes to the new branch. It does not affect the original branch right now. We can also see the log. There is no Radhe commit message here. So what we will do is merge the new branch with the master, with the main branch. For that, we have to be on the parent branch first. Then we write git merge and the name of child branch, which is new branch. So it has merged both the branches and created a new commit. It doesn't show there are no issues.
Sanket, your voice is breaking a bit.
Is it audible?
Yeah.
So we have pushed to return and we can just refresh and see that the Radhe part is also added here. Okay. So have you understood this part? If you have any doubts, please ask, because branching is one of the prerequisite of contributing to open source.
Your voice is breaking. Could you could you put in the chat area?
You are not audible.
Listen, buddy, could you put it on the chat? Shall we continue? Buddy, if you want, I don't know who it is, but you can put it in the chat. If you can't, if you're saying that you can't access the chat, you can put it on any group which contains any of us, and we'll be happy to answer updates if you're on it. Okay, so now for my favorite part of the session is, okay, what is staging area? Shubham, Sanket would be answering this in the chat, and I'll be showing that also, if it's possible. So before we start open source, I want to
let me stop the screen share.
Oh yeah, I have to start. Yeah. Okay, is the screen visible, guys?
Yes.
Great. So one thing I had to show these three repositories, but one of you asked how can I use GitHub on phone, so I'll just do that. So where is the ACM Git of Sanket? Okay, this is ACM Git, right? Now, if I want to add a file to this and I have access, there are three buttons that you can see here, right? This really help because you can just go to any of these files, or you can just, you know, add your own file if you want. Say, if I want to upload a file, I can just pick anything up now. For the time being, I'll just upload, I'll upload this photo of my friend, okay? because why not? And see, it's that easy. His photo is now there, and I guess it's visible for you. He is not the best looking person, but yeah, so that's possible. You can use these buttons, and also, as I mentioned, GitHub is coming with something called as Code Spaces. Now, what is GitHub's Code Spaces? Is it's a beta version where you can, you know, write your own code. You can make the changes directly. I have requested for early access. I haven't yet got it, but you can change the code in the app, it's in the website itself, and therefore it really helps out a lot of times. Another thing that I will share with you, I'm not sure if it works as of now, but something we have to do is just we write v1 dot and v1 dot github, something like that we do, and it works. It's still under progress, but I'll send it to you. Okay, so let's start with open source. This is the slide. Guys, I want you to tell which these logos are, other than the WCACM logo. Anybody wants to go ahead?
Firefox.
Great. Firefox is right.
Yeah. Linux.
Linux. Yeah, the penguin is correct. Then?
Yes. VLC Media.
Perfect.
Python.
8.9.
Python was correct. And what?
Flannel 9.
Nope. Ye pata hai kisi ko? Orange color.
Blender.
Theek se nahi sunai diya. Can you go ahead?
Blender.
Nope. Okay. Who said Blender? That's right. The orange one. Yeah, it's Blender. And who knows this gecko? The pencil gecko. Come on. Nobody knows this. Shocking. Okay, so I'll tell you what that is. It's one of the most important thing for any programmer. It's Notepad++. It's an open source IDE. I hope you've heard about it. C and C++ coders, kidhar ho. Okay, and next is Audacity. It's an audio editing software, and this, half of you would be knowing this software by the end of the next year. It's React by Facebook. It's one of the most famous open source softwares. So what is open source is anything that is that whose code is open for me. Basically, if I want to see the source code of any of these sites, any of these softwares in your screen or many more, I can just Google it and I get the source code. Then I can copy the source code. I can change it how I want. Like if I say I want that a default Chrome color is pink. If I want it, I can do that. If I was using Mozilla Firefox, because Firefox allows me that. Okay, like that you can you get the entire source code for anything, and that's what open source is. Opposite of open source is closed source. Windows is closed source. You don't know how Windows is working. You don't know how processes are lined up. What is like, you know, how is your process working? You don't know a lot of things about it. Like you probably don't even know how Spider Solitaire is game. The game is made. Pinball, how is it made? Okay, but in Linux, every code is open source. Okay, and I want to just show you how open source code looks like. This is for React. Now React, it's a front end library, as I had said. It's used for making websites, and popular React websites are Instagram, Instagram's made on React Native on the app, and this site it's made on Instagram web is made on React. Okay, so if you see this, you can see the entire code base, what all goes in it, you know, who contributed it. Every day, till date, 6.4 million people have used React. 6.4 million is such a big number that, you know, it's probably the population of Russia or something. It's very huge. And 1500 people have contributed to React, and they have made changes. They have improved the language. Someday it could be you also who will be making those changes. Now everything is there inside. If you want to download the code, you can follow the steps. Git clone and the React code will be on your device. You can make the changes. Everything is yours. Now, before we move on, I want to show you two personal projects of that we have done since last year. One of them is Quizzer API. Quizzer API is a API which fetches you quiz questions. Now, it's a very silly thing that we made. It was just it was around your age, like in May when we were just bored. Like, I guess, okay, it's not that. It's 9 months ago. So we had decided, you know what, let's my friend came to my house. He was like, you know, I want to create a quiz app, but I don't know where to get the quiz questions. So I'm like, let's make an API which will do that for you. Now, what we did is all the quiz questions that we wanted are here. If you can see, like which of these is not an A? Gorilla, chimpanzee, orangutan, monkey, and the answer. Very simple code. We didn't know a lot of programming. All we knew was this. And then we created this entire sheet of 368 questions till today. And we just hosted it on a basic React Node and Express website. And this was it. Today it has 10 contributors and it's active on this place. Hold on, I'll just show you the deployment also if you're interested. So, I just put this in the chat. Okay, what the error occurred, I'll check this later, but I'll just put the link because I want you to contribute to this. If this is the best place to start contributions. Okay, now another one of the softwares that I want to share is Indian name generator. Okay, this may be a bit okay, I'll just show you what it does. It has a list of all the names, Marathi names and etc. Like just Arav, Shiti, Shantanu, Ongar. These are all my friends. By the way, this is all the CSE class. And we just made this and this. So what you can do is if you want some Indian names, you can directly just use this NPM and it will just give you Marathi male name and it will give you a name. It's a very simple thing. Anyone can do this. But what happened was today when we were researching for the project, we found that someone used our project. There was this girl. I don't know her name. It's Sniga. Okay. What she did was she made an application using our library. What it did is it finds you your soulmate's name. Okay. So I want you to tell anybody's name here. Anybody. who wants to tell their name or their friend's name? I'll provoke you. No, you. I'm not your friend. No, I'm not your friend. Who else?
Omkar.
Omkar, right?
Omkar.
The CR, na?
The Balatrao Patil.
Proton.
Pro 7. Okay. What is the birth date of Omkar? Kisi ko pata? I don't know how this app works. I just found out that someone has made it. Come on. Omkar, kya hai tera birthday? अरे ओके लेट जस्ट से ही वाज बोर्न यस्टरडे ठीक है आई डोंट माइंड ओके
अरे चैट मध्ये टाक देते हैं
चैट 27/08/2001
ओके गिव मी अ सेकंड इट्स
27
ओके 27 व्हाई इज इट नॉट वर्किंग ओ गॉड शिट ओके बाप दिस विल टेक अ व्हाइल ओके 2001 मध्ये हाउ आर यू 2001 एंड इन सेकंड इयर ओके लेट्स ओमकार मेल एंड 26th मे
ओके यू नो व्हाट 27th ऑगस्ट
ठीक है 27th ओके इट्स नॉट वर्किंग एज आई वांटेड टू वर्क बट ओके हां आहे बट तो वेळ घेईल ना तेवढा बट ठीक आहे चल करूया आता हे जस्ट एक्सपेरिमेंटेड हे ओपन सोर्स नाही आहे टेक्निकली दिस इज शिट ओके ओके दिस इज फन ओके अँड ठीक आहे हे होता आहे ॲप्लिकेशन देन दिस इज वॉट समवन मेड युझिंग दिस लायब्ररी ऑफ माइन अँड यू कॅन ऑल्सो यूज इट आय बेग यू टू यूज इट इट्स रिअली फन And like this, I made some stuff. I'm not a good coder, but this was just time pass that we did. And you can all see, it has my name and everything. So see, as someone asked, I think it was Vishal, right? Vishal, are you still there?
Yes.
Awesome. So Vishal, you asked which language do I use to code, right? I just wanted to tell you that this is coded entirely in Python. Simple Python, you can see, okay, it's JavaScript, damn. Okay, JavaScript, Omkar made a Python version for this, Omkar Gavli, if you know. So, sometimes you don't need anything to contribute to open source. I'll show you something called Awesome Travel, okay? It's a repository which suggests you places to travel, okay? And it just gives you data. This doesn't use any kind of code, but it's still very helpful. A lot of developers have used it. Like you can see 144 stars is not a joke on GitHub. So you can see to help in open source, you don't need to learn to code. Yes, there are projects like React, which require you hardcore coding, right? And there's also languages that require, but most of the times, all you need is your interest and enthusiasm. Everything else just follows. Okay. Now I've been distracted for a bit now. So let's come back. What's your issue? Every open source project starts with an issue. Okay, so if you see React, there are 530 issues as of, okay, 531. One came as we were talking. Now, what is an issue is someone sees something in the code and thinks that, you know what, this is not right. Maybe I can improve this. And that person could also be the creator of the repository. Like anybody can create an issue, the creator or say, I feel this can be improved. So I will just create an issue and I'll just write it down. Then someone else will read this. Someone will tell them, I don't think there is a need to do this. Or someone else will come and say, okay, I know how to fix this. Can I do this? And if they allow that, then their project, they have to, the next steps Sanket will tell you. But what you have to do is you have to see that issues are what start development of open source. You have to read issues, can I improve this? I can always see a bug in the initial stage. I don't understand this. But see, what you see in this is what will tell you, can I improve this? Is there a need for that? See, someone came and helped. You see, this person is not associated with React, but yet he helped. Why? Because open source community is all about creating with help. Like if I have a doubt, I can just put it there. Someone will come and help me. That's what issues are. And it's used for two types. If you want help with your code, you will create an issue. I will, if you want, I'll show you an example. Like Quizzer API has a issue. Okay. It has issues that, hey, I need more questions. like Quizzer API needs 368 questions. We need more questions. So I just made this yesterday. And could you help? And I think Sanket is going to help me very soon. Over to you, Sanket.
Yes, sure. Topic. I just saw a question in the chat that are we testing the code and then uploading it? So it basically depends on how your workflow is constructed and how you want to contribute or how your team performs as a whole. So it's completely your choice to test before uploading to GitHub or test after uploading to GitHub. Both has its advantages and disadvantages, which are right now beyond the scope of this club service. So let's start the next topic, which is forking and pull request. So as we have seen that Devang has created an issue in the Quizzer API repository. One thing to note is that repository is not owned by me. So I cannot freely change any of the code. I can obviously clone it because it is public and make changes locally, but I cannot upload these changes on GitHub because it is not mine. So there comes the concept of forking.
Sanket, have you by chance shared only the screen of that? Like, could you share the entire screen because we weren't able to see Chrome?
Is it visible now?
Try going to Chrome.
अरे क्रोम पर थे.
Okay, नहीं दिख रहा.
दिख रहा.
हाँ क्या? Sorry. मेरे को सिर्फ उसका PPT दिख रहा है. Sorry.
दिख रहा ना?
नहीं क्रोम नहीं दिख रहा.
PPT दिख रहा.
अरे PPT क्रोम पे ही है.
संकेत, could you reshare the entire window?
अरे थैंक्स कर गिटहब दिखते आता
या
आता
हो
हमो का प्रॉब्लम है
गो टू गिटहब अगेन ओके
अरे मी उघडलंच नव्हतं गिटहब अजून
ओ सॉरी
हां तर कुठे होतो आपण हां So basically, since that repository is not mine, I cannot freely change in that. So here comes the concept of forking. So forking, what forking does is that we create a copy of that account's repository onto our account. And since that copy is on our account, we can do anything with it. So let us see how we can fork. So here is the fork button. This is the Quizzer API. These are the two issues. We will come back to issues later. This is how we can fork. We click the fork button and I am in two organizations. One is basically the ACM developers and one general one, which is by default. So I'll select the one. You may not have this pop-up. It is saying it is forking. It should take few seconds. And we have forked the repository. We can see that we are on Sanket Sonavane 303/Quizzer API and not on alpha/Quizzer API. This is a copy which was forked from the original repository. Now we can freely do anything in this because this is my copy. So there are basically two reasons why you may want to fork a repository. One is that you may find some interesting repository that you may want to experiment with or to try out new features or just do random stuff. And the second one is for contributing in open source. So we have now forked a repository. Let's clone the repository. I will copy the URL and we'll go here and git clone the URL. Okay, so we have cloned it. Here is the folder. Let us go. Oh, it's updating. Okay, let us open it. So we have completed the step one of open source, which is forking a repository. The step two is creating a branch. So let us create a branch. Let us name it new. We have created it and switched to the new branch. We are on the new branch. So why do we want to create a branch? So we can always make changes in the main or master branch, but what the problem is that we may have made changes and somebody else has may have made changes in the original repository. So when we try to sync them so that we both the repositories are on the same page, we may get issues. So we will create a new branch which gives us a safe area to experiment. So after creating new branch, let us go to the questions and index.json, and we will add a new question here. So the ID of new question will be incremented. So previous was 368, this is 369. Difficulty we will set to 2. Question, let's take how much time take for Jupyter to get a revolution.
Kya answer
hai? Yes. Darenge na answer pe darenge. So let us add options. First is 12 years, which is the correct option. Add random numbers. No, 13 years. Mark the answer as A. So we have added a new question, but these are only local changes, we haven't even committed them. So let us check the status. The status says we are on the branch new B and we have modified the file question/index.json. Let us stage it. Instead of dot, let us use the actual file name question/index.json. On. Have staged the file. So now we will come in with the message question 3 added. Now we have created a branch. We have added a commit to the branch, but this branch is not on GitHub. Here there are other branches, master, Devang and rising entropy and other branches, but there is no the branch we created right now is not present here. So we have to push this branch to GitHub. So we will use git push origin newbie. We have pushed a new branch here. As we can see, there is a new branch. We can check out what the code here is, and it says that newbie has had recent pushes less than a minute ago. Compare and pull request. So what a pull request is, like now we have created some changes and we want that it should be included in the original repository. We cannot do that directly. So we created a copy, we created a branch, and we did it. What the changes we wanted to do. Now we have to request the maintainers or the owners of the original repository that we want you to merge our changes with your code. That is what basically a pull request. We want them to pull our changes into their code. So let us click the button compare and pull request. Just a minute. Okay, we cannot see issues here. Okay, here issues. Each issue has a unique ID. We can specify this ID to make sure that a pull request is associated with a particular issue, or we can do it without even mentioning the issue, like randomly just we have a generator pull request. But it is best to assign the pull request to a particular issue so that it is easier for the maintainer who will review your request to accept and review, so that he will not need to search what exactly is the issue in a list of say like 1,000 issues. You have already mentioned it. Right now we are not mentioning anything and just create the pull request. So this pull request is created and its status is open. Now Devang will show how owner or a maintainer will accept this pull request. And after he merges the pull request, I will show what the status is and tell some.
Okay, so screen dikh raha hai guys? So okay, there were no pull requests right now. So abhi Sanket made a pull request. I can see that. So yeah, you know, whenever you make a change, because it's my repository or my friend's repository or any repository, you won't be directly able to change it. So you have to create a pull request. Like I request you to change this code. Okay, so I see this request by Sanket by 33 seconds ago. So let me just check what he did. So what he did is he just went here. There was nothing and he added these lines. He added one question for me. And it's a good, I have to check the code. Like, so who is the one who is merging has to see if the added code is actually the solution to the problem or not. You can actually, you know what, if I don't like it, I can just go ahead and reject it. Like I can ask him, you know, make some changes and then I'll tell you, or I say I can approve it, or I can do anything. I can comment on his code also, okay, what you did, you know what, it's okay. But I don't think it's a 2 difficulty question. I think it's a 3 difficulty question. Okay, but because Sanket is my friend, I'm going to let it pass. And you see this, there it's no conflict. If you see the syntax is etc is correct. So I will just go here and it tells me that there is no conflict with the main branch, which means if I'm adding a code, it's not breaking my previous code. GitHub is that smart. It will tell you that. So we can just merge the pull request and you can say confirm. And in that way it merges. And right now what Sanket has just did is he has contributed to open source. So it could be this easy as well. You can just help us with questions and I can, and yes, Quizzer API itself, you may think that it's not the very smartest of the codes, like who will be using it, etc. But what is this happening? I will share you some links where how it was actually used by people, etc. You can also use it for your next project. I think IT has been given an assignment, right? ITCS, that you have to create a C project. You can use a quiz. You can make a quiz app using this. And trust me, you will get good marks because you are using HTTP requests. Okay. And with that, Sanket has been added as a collaborate contributor to the project. Congrats, Sanket. And okay, so that's what we wanted to tell you about merging. So this in entirety is what open source is all about. You look for an issue, if you think you can do it, you ask it, hey, I want to do this, could you assign it to me? And then you can fork it, then you make changes as you want and you make a pull request. If I like the pull request, I will accept it. If I don't, I will ask you to make some changes. And with that, the formal session has come to an end, but we want to
thumbs up azum bakhi
are
don't want
yeah like okay I was going to start a monologue but theek hai
screen diste na
yeah it's visible
so as we seen that Devang has merged the pull request we see the status marked as merged now GitHub recommends that we delete this branch because the purpose of this branch is over so let us delete it so basically why this is needed is that each pull request should be in its separate branch so that contents do not get merged and the pull request do not get merged accidentally which will make it difficult to manage both for the creator of the request and the acceptor of the request one more thing to be added is that fork is not a dynamic copy it is just a static copy which was created at the time when we clicked the button so after let's say 10 days that 100 and more people will contribute to the same repository but I will not see that changes in my copy of the repository this is because it is a static copy so that's what the second part of the open source is that syncing the original repo with our fork repo but it requires some advanced topics such as rebasing so we shall take it in a later plug service and that's all from my side any doubts are welcome
and before that I just want to you know give a monologue okay finally we want to tell you three things about development if you want to start is start small but start early which means you don't have to you know directly start contributing to React Native or anything by Microsoft etc you can start very small in fact by the end of the session we'll be sending you some very simple repos which will require little to no coding you can contribute to Quizzer API we would love your contributions it's open the issues are still open you can please apply I'll send you the links and you can also contribute a name generator where you can make projects if you want or you can add more names we are always in need of names there's many more that we have compiled a list and now I just want to tell you that you don't have to you know start directly with this you can just contribute to anybody see if I find this interesting if I see I can add something here I can you know just fork it and I can change his code as well or remove code anybody GitHub is very open anybody can make any changes now see this is beautiful right you can make this for your own self also you can directly just fork it put it on your own repository and make this your readme it's that easy then you don't have to be great to start but you have to be start to be great then don't be afraid to explore don't be scared to ask a lot of mistakes that we made in first year is that we didn't explore this very early on we were just one of the coders right sab log cctp karte the python to shayad last mein sikha hoga but we would suggest that you in very small steps you start exploring development also maybe html css you can start with that then you can move on to anything that you like if you learn python you will open your gates to many technologies and don't be scared to ask if you have any kind of technical doubts etc the first people that you should be approaching is your seniors we at ACM would love to help out anytime we are very approachable also we are very active on WhatsApp anywhere Instagram LinkedIn so do approach us and we will try to guide you we are not experts but yeah we understand what you have gone through so yeah and just start and explore that's what I will say don't just be limited to solving 3 questions or 5 questions a day on HackerRank or CodeShift theek hai learn and grow together it's more fun try to make friends in college try to make try to grow with them you know you don't have to make projects together you don't have to make your solo projects it's very boring like me and my friend made this in 3 days because like it's fun right we were just talking all the way Google Meet etc and we were learning deployment and all it was so much fun to learn mini projects it's trust me it's better than doing alone and most of the great things are made when it's done in a group so try to have a group and try to enjoy development With that, we want to take a short quiz.
घाबरून नका जाऊ, तुम्ही स्वतःचे पर्सनल प्रोजेक्ट्स बनवा, तुम्ही शिका आधी, मग पण नंतर पण तुम्ही कॉन्ट्रीब्यूट करू शकता ओपन सोर्स मध्ये, एवढी घाई अशी काही नाहीये.
ओके, आणि घाई नाहीये पण करा नक्की, असं जाऊ देऊ नका याला खाली. ओके, पर क्विज चालू करायची का आपण? तयार आहात ना सगळे? का झोप आली आहे, ब्रेक घ्यायचा आहे?
हॅलो,
हा
हा, एम आय ऑडिबल? पियुष. सो गाइज, लेट्स टेक अ क्विज. आय एम शेअरिंग विंडो, जस्ट अ मिनिट. Is it visible?
Yes.
Join to the link. I have posted it on chat box. And try karo apne naam se hi aana. Jo
bhi part le sakta ho
kare. Haan, le sakte ho.
Are apna quiz banwali, apna kaise lagaye?
Nahi, nepotism.
Gladiator apne naam se aaya.
कॉन्ग्रेचुलेशन.
मैं बाकी हूँ,
आजा भाई,
आजा आजा.
खुद को भी नहीं आता जाता. सो
बहुत इजी रखा हमने इस बार.
हाँ,
सो लेट्स स्टार्ट करते. देवांगी है, देवांग हुई है?
नहीं नहीं, मैं नहीं हूँ, बट करते स्टार्ट.
अच्छा, हेलो
या
सो कौन है देव्स
देव्स मैं हूँ उसको इग्नोर कर
ओके एंड ममता
ममता कौन है
ममता कौन है
दीदी किधर हो
स्क्रीनशॉट भेज देना रिजल्ट का हम इंस्टा पे डाल देंगे
यार ये विनर को कुछ देने का है इसलिए
हाँ फीडबैक
शाउट आउट
हाँ नहीं दे नरेंद्र बैनर्जी जो है उसको स्पेशल शाउट आउट वेरी नाइस नेम ओके ज्ञानेश्वर इज इट यू इबारे
यस यस
ग्रेट कांग्रेचुलेशंस राज
नमस्ते मला वाटले या फ्रेशर डे खास
अरे तो फोर्थ वाला संकेत मी नहीं है मी पार्टस नहीं घेतला
ओके हु इज इट गाइस
ये
ओके ग्रेट संजय इज संजय विशाल आई गेस रोहन कौन है बोल रहे
हां हां यस
सो विशाल यू आर द आई थिंक यू आर द सेकंड वन अमंग योर टीम एंड नॉट वेश इट्स विबाइट्स इट्स नॉट वेश नेवी फॉर श्योर
एंड या फॉर सेट यू तो ना रे
बट मजा आया गाइस
आई होप टू जॉइन करेस
तो हमारा बनना ना तो
एनीवेज गाइस थैंक यू सो मच और या एक लास्ट स्लाइड पे आना गाइस अच्छा यू कैन स्टॉप मे बी प्रेजेंटिंग वी विल टेक इट बैक So, any questions? Puchho, guys. Any one of you still has any doubts of contributing, starting to contribute, or you know, what should I learn next? This is the perfect time to ask, and there are a lot of seniors right now who will be willing to answer. Kuch bhi career related doubt hai, ya fir kuch ESC related doubt hai. You know, this is the time to ask. Come on. डरो मत चैट में डालो मैं नहीं देखूंगा कोई और देख लेगा आप बट गाइस कोई नहीं है क्या यस देवांग अवेलेबल अच्छा फिर फील फ्री टू आस्क फॉर मोर फीस ओके फीडबैक क्वेश्चंस नहीं है किसी को गाइस तो वी कैन यू नो स्टॉप प्रेजेंटिंग देन अगर नहीं है तो ठीक है जाने से पहले
सबसे पहले आज जाके गिट का अकाउंट बनाओ अपनी अपनी रीडमी फाइल बनाओ उसमें फोटोज डालो अपने
और मेरे को फॉलो करो गाइस
करो हां
मैं लिंक भेज दूंगा वी विल जस्ट सेंड यू ऑल द इजी इजी रिपोजिटरीज टू कंट्रीब्यूट मेक श्योर यू डू दैट मेक श्योर यू इंक्रीज योर स्टार रेटिंग और मेक श्योर यू इंक्रीज योर कंट्रीब्यूशन रेटिंग आई विल जस्ट शो यू व्हाट अ कंट्रीब्यूशन रेटिंग इज लाइक एवरी डे दैट यू कोड एवरी डे दैट यू कंट्रीब्यूट it shows up here in green color okay and this is a matter of pride for any developer that you have commit you commit every day or something so yeah try to commit and try to explore make this green dots and one day we'll see you becoming a great developer right so thank you keep exploring and never stop coding hi guys
देवांगे थे डाउट है एंड्रॉइड से काय काय करू शकतो
एनीबॉडी वांट्स टू टेक सीनियर्स
एंड्रॉइड वरून तसं जास्त काय करता नाही येणार ऍक्च्युअल डेव्हलपमेंट किंवा सीपी करायला पण लॅपटॉप गरजेचं आहे लॅपटॉप किंवा डेस्कटॉप काही पण मोबाईल नको
एक ना सिद्धार्थ करके एक सीनियर आहे उसको तुम कंसल्ट करो. ही टिल नाउ डज एवरीथिंग ऑन लाइक मोबाइल, सो आई थिंक ही कैन हेल्प यू मच बेटर.
या और फाइनली देख ब्रिजेश, यू कैन कंट्रीब्यूट एज आई सेड ना. आई डोंट हैव, मेरे पास फोन नहीं है दिखाने के लिए, बट देख गिट हर चीज का एक वेब ऐप होता है, गिटहब का भी वेब ऐप है. सो इफ यू पॉसिबल ना तो तेरे इसमें फोक करके, सॉरी किया है राइट, फोकिंग वगैरह ट्राई. एग्जैक्टली, सो होता है. हाँ बता बता.
और वो जो आप सीनियर का नंबर कह रहे हो वो मेरे को कहाँ से मिलेगा?
वैष्णवी भेज देगी देखो ग्रुप पे. ठीक है ओके. ठीक है और किसी को अगर डाउट्स गाइस, एंड्रॉइड से बहुत कुछ कर सकते हो, इतना मत सोचो. देखो रिसोर्सेज से ज्यादा तुम्हारा एंथुसियाज्म इंपॉर्टेंट है.
फोन पे सीख सकते हो पर इट्स नॉट द मोस्ट एफिशिएंट थिंग टू डू.
या
और बड़े प्रोजेक्ट्स नहीं हैंगल होंगे फोन पे.
ठीक है और कुछ? थैंक्स फॉर द सेशन आदित्य. Thanks for attending. Thanks for taking the time out, guys. Or, ठीक है. Anything else? पूछो guys. अभी time है. Next session किस पे चाहिए आपको? Like हम सोच रहे थे कि हम लोग एक bootcamp types रखे for web development या app development अगर interest हो तो. But again हमें पता है कि आप में से बहुत लोगों के पास शायद computer का access नहीं है इस point of time पे. So like if you want anything else for next chat, aapko feedback form mein dal dena and we'd love to take note of it. Okay. App development. Achha, koi bata sak? Achha, Clawless start. Okay, let's answer that first. Bhai, cases dekh raha hai? Anurag? Ruk, app development dekhna tha kya? Hello? Okay. Anybody wants to take from the senior stakes for किसको roadmap बताना है basic app development का, कहाँ से start करे वगैरह, जिसने भी किया हो. Okay, there's no one. Aditya, I'll message you. Okay, we are in touch, so I'll message you something. If you want to go in that direction, we'll surely figure something out. How to search for topics, like how to filter? Prathamesh has asked. Okay. Dek, we had a lot of problems searching that like that. So I'll tell you the best way to do is you go to Explore. And on Explore, you can see, there's topics out around here. Okay, like if you want to contribute to Django, you'll find all the code that was written in Django, every code, right? And you can just see where I can contribute. So if it can be a simple topic also, considering this, or it can be an algorithms also. It could be say APIs also, you can create public APIs like we did. Awesome Lists is one of the most unique things, that it doesn't require a single line of code, but it has so many things. Like if you have awesome Python, it will have all the Python libraries that are very interesting to study. It will also have what you can do with Python. Say data science mein kisi ko kuch karna, authentication ke liye, like what you want. So like isme you can contribute, starting very simple. Also, hold on. There is also something called labels. Like you see this green color one, this type bug, good first issue. See, good first issue is one of the most important labels, because this is what we code for. See, every issue with a good first issue means that beginner only hai, aap bhi try kar sakte ho, isse aap contribute karna start karo. Uske alawa C mein agar karna hai, Chrome is also guys aadha open source hai. There's something called Chrome Canary jis pe aap bhi kar sakte ho contribute. Har ek topic hota hai. C++ is also like, ab abhi agar if I just do a latest commit, na, it's all C, lead code questions, etc. Now I know a lot of you are doing that, so you would also love it. So you can start to contribute here. Also, more than contributing, khud ka project banake being a moderator is also open source. So try to come up with unique things that don't exist, right? Like the quizzer or the name generator. It may be silly, but it may help someone out someday. Okay. So explore karte jao. Sometimes it will take you days and days, and you'll find some great projects to learn. documentation. Okay, this is also important, guys. Agar, if you don't know a lot of coding, you can contribute to documentations of projects, which is a lot of developers don't like documentations, but it's very important also, right? Okay, that's from my side. Sankeet, you want to add anything to this question?
नहीं नहीं सगळं कवर केलंस तू.
Okay.
आणि हा एक सांगायचंय, वेळ लागेल शिकायला. आम्ही पण कधी कधी महिने महिने एकाच वस्तूला शिकायला लावले, घाबरू नका कशाच. टेन्शन नाही घ्यायचं
हिमांत, म्हणून तर ना जोडी यू नीड अ टीम फॉर दॅट. ट्राय टू डू गेट दॅट. ठीक आहे, अगर कुछ नहीं है तो एंड करते हैं गाइस. थैंक यू ऑल फॉर ज्वाइनिंग एंड इट वाज रियली एक्साइटिंग. एंड इफ बाय चांस इफ आई मेड अ मिस्टेक और आई हर्ट एनीबडी लाइक दिव्या और ओमकार, वी आर रियली सॉरी अबाउट दैट. ओके, एंड इफ यू नीड अ बिट मोर एंड इफ यू थिंक दैट दिस वाज टू लैक्स, लाइक इफ आई वाज नॉट वेरी डिसिप्लिन्ड व्हेन आई वाज टीचिंग, इट्स ओके, यू कैन राइट इन द फीडबैक एंड वी विल ट्राई टू इम्प्रूव इट सिंस नेक्स्ट टाइम. बट या चलो,
और कुछ डाउट होगा तो मैसेज करना.
हाँ, अपडेट्स पे करो या फिर मेरे को लिंक्डइन या गिटहब पे राइजिंग एंट्रोपी मिल जाएंगे. Yeah.